It's a beauty blog, and okay, stop again. Hi, welcome to my video. Just in case you're wondering why I'm even on here making this video, I have a blog, a beauty blog, and one of my readers had commented, and some had emailed that they would like to see if it makes any sense to take pictures to put on a blog, just too many pictures, especially to put in just one post. So I thought, you know, why not try my hand at making a video? Yeah, so wish me luck with this. So I have three things to say. One, I'm not bragging. This is pretty much everything, so really not enough to brag about. Two, I love these kind of videos. I watch them every day, every night. I love the ones where it's just a girl talking into her camera, and then I kind of wanted a starting point, a recording, a snapshot of where I am now with regards to my collection. On my blog, I've definitely noticed an increase from when I first started blogging a couple years ago to what my collection looks now. So I just wanted to see if, you know, that trend was going to continue. I go through phases, you know, a day with me. Please subscribe. I'm still new. I'm still figuring YouTube out. But please subscribe and like so I can, you know people are watching. And yeah, thanks. Let's get started. La, 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 la.
I'm going to start off by showing you guys the whole kit and caboodle. Over here, as you can see, I have a small towel made out of Muji drawers. The top one is the two thick Muji drawers with the flip top. And then I have two of the three drawers stacked at the bottom. Over here I have an acrylic container I bought at the container store. This is my perfumes, some random brushes, and a candle. Then I have this apothecary jar full of samples, and more samples to the side of it. I also have laid out in front some of my foundations. They typically live over here, but it was kind of hard to move them and try to figure out focusing all at the same time. So yeah, I have my Estee Lauder Perfection Lumiere, which is my absolute holy grail foundation. Dior Nude. I know there's a new Dior out. I'm interested in getting it, but just haven't pulled the trigger yet. My only drugstore foundation, the CoverGirl Queen, which took me forever to be able to find that, and I was so excited to find it was a match. I typically don't like to buy drugstore foundations because I hate to buy it, try it out, can't test it, blah, blah. I hate that. So I was very happy that this one was a match. And then a NARS Sheer Glow. This little thing here is in a giveaway I'm doing on Instagram, which might probably be over by the time this video goes up, but yeah, it's the Amorezzi palette by Anastasia Beverly Hills. So I'll start with the stack. The top drawer is just mainly Chanel foundations. Right there you see my absolute favorite mascara. The Le Volume de Chanel mascara. I think it's the best mascara in the world. My Le Beige powder, I have this in number 60. I use it all the time. And then I prefer to keep the compacts in their little pouches, just keeps them nice and clean. And I have some lippies over here. I try to keep my stuff by brand. Doesn't always work that way, but it's kind of how it's mainly organized. So here I have mainly Guerlain, so lippy in there, Guerlain powder. This is a brush. Again, I'd like to keep it clean, lippies. And then I have the Simpsons MAC powder, the pink one, pink sprinkles. I bought that for the packaging. I happily admit that. I haven't even tried it yet. Over here are some lippies and blushes in the back. Like I said, I don't keep things by brand, more by what I use them for. I like to try out the high-end ones. They are a little pricey, so I like to just buy one at a time so I can see if I like them. I love the NYX Butter Glosses. And then, like I said, some blushes in the back. These are my three favorite: Marc Jacobs, Bobbi Brown, and NARS. Next is my absolute favorite drawer. Mainly YSL. Love my Touche Clot, my lipsticks, and the... Oh gosh, I love these lipsticks. I also have a Tom Ford primer. And then my MAC Alluring Aquatics and MAC Pedro Laurencio. I have a blog post about MAC. I stopped using it for years, and then it seems like this last year I've just caught the bug and have started buying it again. This is my second favorite drawer. This is all Estee Lauder. This is my compact, my highlighter that I use almost every day. This is the Violet something, I forget. Palette, and then some other eyeshadows and lippies and eyeliner. I just love Estee Lauder. I know it has a granny image, but I love it. More eyeshadows, Lorac Pro, which I use practically every day. The Wet n Wild Comfort Zone. NYX in Love, which as you can see, I hit pan on two of them and then two fell out when it broke. Then the absolutely wonderful Milani eyeshadows, the new ones, love them. This is also fast becoming a favorite. This is my blushes, drugstore edition, mainly NYX and Milani. Love these two. And then last is kind of like whatever doesn't fit, fits here. The Nudes Maybelline palette, haven't even opened it yet. And then the NYX Butter Naked. I hate it when I have makeup that I'm not using. I honestly feel like it's so wasteful and that I've wasted my money. So this is why I don't have a lot of makeup to begin with, because I want to feel like I'm getting my money's worth. I have the Guerlain Meteorites here, the old one. My favorite powder in the world, the La Mer, the powder. I look so good with that on. I have it in the color beige and color wise. So this is my drugstore versions. Again, I don't, here it's just like a hodgepodge of things thrown in. Probably because it's less expensive stuff. Then I just have random eyeliners and a NYX jumbo pencil. And I love this blush too, the Physician's Formula, but it couldn't fit in here. So it is over here with the rest of my NYX eyeshadows. And I have some Mary Kay over there. And then I have two of these. So it's, you know, sometimes it's where stuff will fit. Random brushes. And I actually... Those two I actually won in a gift basket at Neiman Marcus. I was there for some kind of beauty event and my name was pulled out of a hat. So I've yet to open them. I have no idea what they smell like, but one day I will. And then last but not least is my jumbo apothecary jar that just has all kinds of samples. I mean, just you name it, I've got it. I was supposed to finish that. There's not much left of that. So I often will go through here, especially when I'm traveling. I'll find perfume or I'll find skincare I can use so that I don't have to take a lot of my travel bag. I will grab things out of here and use them with me. And I have on occasion found something to buy. So I love it. So that's it. It's not much, it's not huge. I think it's manageable. It's perfect, it's just for me. I have some other items in my makeup bag that's in my purse. And then I have some other items that might be in my vanity in my bathroom. Again, just a small amount, things like concealer and maybe two or three other mascaras that are open. But yeah, that's about it. I mean, it's small, it's manageable, and it was all paid for by my own money. Thank you.